Welcome to Dr. Jester Rants, and I'm gonna rant about this. From the Federalist. Chinese owned TikTok and WeChat have 45 days to sell or leave United States. TikTok has 45 days from Thursday to find a buyer for its US operations or the popular social media site will be banned, according to an executive order signed by President Trump. On Thursday evening, he signed another order later that evening enacting a similar ban on WeChat, a social network messaging platform and forum for online payments. He's right, you know, Trump did the excellent thing. And this is not the first country that actually does this. India has done the same. And they have plenty of messages, of evidence proving that these two apps, websites, or whatever you want to call them, that they steal people's information and then the Chinese government uses it for their own communist goals or to try and affect the local populace, you know, try to enact communism, censorship and other things. And the interesting bit is that the TDSers, mostly the media in this case, have gone completely unhinged on this. They were reporting about the Chinese stuff on their apps before, even David Hogg, who said that TikTok was bad, but then later on, after Trump said about this, he condemned it and said that Trump is getting triggered by a bunch of teens on an app. That's how bad things have gotten with the TDSers. Anyway, here the local media reported this as if it was kind of a great insult to everything. They've reported it that they had no evidence that any of these things were happening on those platforms, even though Apple themselves, Apple, let that shit sink in, Apple themselves said and showed the evidence of what TikTok was doing. And they failed to mention that on the local media here, and they then decided to try and defend the Chinese government and say, oh, poor the Chinese, they use this to communicate between each other. How are they going to communicate now? They're forgetting that the Chinese can still use those apps in China, not in America. They made it sound like all the Chinese people, including those in China, would also be affected. That's not how it is, not how it works. Even the media here is so blatantly anti-Trump and so pro-China that we barely even had a peep about the Hong Kong protests. And when the corona or the Wuhan flu came, or Wuhan virus if you prefer, came, they tried to downplay it initially and pretty much tried to defend China in most cases. For instance, the best example is that they are kind of playing like the Chinese vaccine is like the second coming of Christ. That's how bad it has become, the media here. And then there's the fact that we never even heard a single tiny little peep about the Three Gorges Dam. Not even a tiny little, oh look, China is having problems with the Three Gorges Dam. Nothing. I only became aware of this from the international media, from newspapers internationally. Otherwise, nothing. And then they haven't made a single peep about the concentration camps in China, the organs harvesting, or even much less about the hair smuggling that they took from prisoners, Uyghurs prisoners, or even recently of the leaked video where a bunch of prisoners were being relocated to a concentration camp. Not even a single tiny little peep. That's how bad it has become. It's absurd. Alright, back to the news. TikTok has presented national security concerns have circled the platforms for months. Due to both companies being owned by the Chinese entities, TikTok is owned by ByteDance, a Chinese tech company which has joint ventures with state-run entities. WeChat is owned by Chinese tech company Tencent, which faces accusations of censoring private conversations. Both face accusations of censoring content that is politically undesirable for the Chinese Communist Party and sharing user data with the Chinese government. And it gets worse, because every single company here, ByteDance and Tencent, they are both owned by, you guessed it, by the Chinese Communist Party. It's a kind of a requirement in China that every single company, every single thing, including international companies that tries and plans to sell in China, at least the local branch of said international company needs to be partially owned by the communists, by the Communist Party. It's a fascist kind of system. Well, then again, fascism and communism all come from socialism. So there you go. But so that means, for instance, that ByteDance and Tencent is also owned by the Communist Party in China. And yes, that also means that Epic Game Store is also partially owned by the Chinese Communist Party, because that's how it works down in China. And Tencent is also responsible for facial recognition software and other things that the Chinese government is using to censor its citizens and jail the dissenting voice, kind of like the paradise the SJWs want. In regards to accusations of censorship and its associated risk, the executive order against TikTok states, TikTok also reportedly censors content that the Chinese Communist Party deems politically sensitive, such as contents concerning protests in Hong Kong, China's treatment of Uyghurs and other Muslim minorities. This mobile application may also be used for disinformation campaigns that benefit the Chinese Communist Party, such as when TikTok videos spread debunk conspiracy theories about the origins of the 2019 Wuhan virus. Yes, the Chinese have been trying to even say that in fact the Wuhan virus came from America. That's how bad it is. As the executive order notes, the risks embedded in TikTok are well established, and the government agencies, both domestically and abroad, have already taken steps to limit its potential influence. The Department of Homeland Security, Transportation Security Administration, and the United States Armed Forces have already banned the use of TikTok on federal government phones. The government of India recently banned the use of TikTok and other Chinese mobile applications throughout the country. In a statement, Indian Ministries of Electronics and Information Technology, MATE, asserted that, asserted that they were stealing and surreptitiously transmitting users' data in an unauthorized manner to servers which have locations outside India. American companies and organizations have begun banning TikTok on their devices. This also comes true to Huawei and other companies as well. The Chinese, they install softwares and etc. that they keep transmitting your information, everything you type, everything you own on the phone. They monitor it and send it back to China. That's insane. WeChat is likewise already limited due to security and privacy fears. WeChat executive order notes, WeChat, like TikTok, also reportedly censors content that the Chinese Communist Party deems politically sensitive and may also be used for disinformation campaigns that benefit the Chinese Communist Party. These risks have led other countries, including Australia and India, to begin restricting or banning the use of WeChat. The United States must take aggressive actions against the owner WeChat to protect our national security. This is also called election meddling. If the Democrats or the control left and the anti-Trumpers got bothered by a fake Russian meddling on the United States election in 2016, then they should really be upset by something that is actually provable like this. There is, however, hope in the form of Microsoft for the millions of teens who could not imagine a world without a bizarrely popular TikTok. The American tech giant has expressed interest in purchasing TikTok's operations in the United States, Australia, Canada, and New Zealand. ByteDance and Microsoft have until September 15 to finalize their deal, or TikTok will be banned in the United States. As of now, there is no such deal to purchase WeChat business interests outside of China. WeChat is also kind of like Chinese Steam. At least you have the basics on this. I think that's it. I've explained everything that you needed to know about this. Well, at least on the superficially, which is the important bit. Before I start stretching out the video with useless information that doesn't really matter much in this case, I'm gonna end it now. Thank you for watching. See you on my next video. Good night.